Hey guys, Ivan here, and this video we are starting with something rather fun, rather interesting. It is a blessing of Awodibu and Nick Walker drama. So these guys are still going back and forth. And this is posed by Matt Jansen, who is Nick's coach. By the way, he was a coach of Dallas McCarver when he was alive. May he rest in peace. And also, he's a coach of the current 2012 Mr. Olympia, Sean Clarida, and so on. He's a top coach, and he's coaching Nick right now. So he posted this photo. This is obviously not recent. This is from his last prep. And you can see how hard, how lean he was at that time. And this look was just ridiculous. I mean, this was insane. Take a look at this. Like a freaking alien. I don't know. So he's not looking like this right now. And we have updates of him right now at 6 weeks out. But here is something interesting. As you can see, I highlighted it. Blessing of Awodibu says, "Geez, Matt, keep that waist trainer on him." And if you guys watch Fuad Abiad's podcast, you saw that moment when Fuad said that Nick has a big waist and Nick got offended, seriously. He believes he has a small waist and he thinks his waist is not bigger than Blessing's. I'm not sure about that. I'm gonna have to see them both on stage. But from what I'm seeing, from what I've seen from the photos on the Instagram, I think Blessing has a smaller waist. And Nick, especially from this front, poses definitely not a guy with the smallest waist ever. And Blessing of Awodibu is taking advantage of that. He's playing mind games. He's he's messing with him. He says, "Keep that waist trainer on." Nick replied something like that sleepy emoji, like you're boring. And then also Blessing replies to him. He says, "I'm only being nice, trying to help you. Make sure you go to sleep with that waist trainer." So he keeps trolling him. But Nick's reaction wasn't probably what Blessing expected it to be. He replied something like, "You're so sweet." And that's it. That's it. Nick didn't really show, at least. I don't know if he was upset, but he didn't show it on the social media. Whether it's getting to Nick or not, I like to see some rivalries. I like to see some mind games. I definitely do like to see guys like that trying to get under the other competitor's skin, you know, trying to mess with them. It's nice, it's really fun, honestly. I mean, we need rivalries in bodybuilding. And this is a most recent physique update of Nick at 6 weeks out of New York Pro, and he weighs in at 270. Guys, 270. That's heavy, that's a lot of weight, that's a lot of muscle. He's a big guy. I mean, Ian Valier, for example, who is also a monster, he was around 250, 255, I believe, at the Mr. Olympia. And Nick is 270 at 6 weeks out, so of course he's gonna die down. He's gonna be probably something like that, similar to Ian, probably 255, maybe 260. I don't know. We'll see. Maybe he's gonna jump. Maybe he's gonna add more gear and maybe get fuller and bigger and harder. Maybe he's gonna remain at 270 or close to it. I don't know. We'll see. But right now, he is getting leaner as we speak. Every time he posts a photo, it is a significant difference. You can see that he's getting more shredded by the time the New York happens. He's gonna be dialed in completely. Here is the back shot, so you can see that the glutes are not exactly, you know, in. But 6 weeks, guys, 6 weeks. If he really wanted, he could be ready in 2 weeks. Yeah, but he has 6 weeks, so I think we can expect great improvements from Nick Walker, potentially, very probably, a New York Pro win. Hunter Labrada. I don't think he is looking much fatter or more watery than these guys. They're doing the New York Pro. We don't know which show he's gonna do, and he says he's looking forward to announcing the show, and it's gonna be happening soon. So we don't know which show is it gonna be, but soon, I mean, how soon? Soon is a relevant term. It could be 6 weeks soon, right? That's pretty soon. It could be 12, 15 weeks. I can't really know this. He didn't announce anything. In the description of this photo, he said, guess which show it's gonna be. So I hope people would be guessing, and maybe he's gonna like or comment on those comments that are actually right. But nobody really commented so much, so I have no idea which show it's gonna be. Could it be New York Pro or Indie Pro or something later in the year? I love me a good guessing game, but let's just wait and see what he announces. As for now, he did make a lot of progress. He's one of those bodybuilders that are actually really devoted to making progress. He's really focused. He's getting stronger by the day. He's eating frequently. He's doing everything that he can, everything that is in his power to make progress. And last year, he was 7th, actually 8th in the world, guys. and he was able to beat Ian earlier that year, so it's arguable maybe he can beat him next time they compete at the Mr. Olympia. So he's a youngster, he turned pro so recently, maybe like 2 years ago, was it? And he's already in the top 10 at the Mr. Olympia, better than top 10, top 8. So let's wait and see what's gonna happen, which show he's gonna do, but I'm pretty sure he's gonna be a favorite to win whichever show he decides to do, and I wish him all the luck. Well, it's been a while since we saw something from William Bonac, and this is his current look in the off-season. So you can get an idea what he looks like, and it's really nothing surprising. I mean, it's barely even worth making a story out of it for my YouTube channel, because William Bonac, he's always in shape, basically. He gets a little bit watery in the off-season, and that's what you can see right here. He's a little bit watery, and he added a tiny little bit of fat. And it's always the same, pretty much. I mean, he already achieved his maximum potential when it comes to muscular development, and he doesn't really need to go and bulk super hard, you know, get fat to get bigger, because where would he add any more muscle? He's a short guy, he's so massive. All he can do, really, is just peak perfectly, like get super lean and then get super full if he manages to do it properly. And if the other guys are a little bit off, he can win. He can win the Mr. Olympia, he can beat them all. I mean, he won the Arnold Classic, he was second at the Mr. Olympia. He doesn't have the best structure, so it's really tough for him to beat the other guys if he's not completely on. And if the other guys bring it, it's gonna be tough for him because of that structure. But as for now, in the off-season, he didn't lose any gains. He looks really big. He looks a little tiny bit chubby. It's not really the best word, but he's not exactly in competition shape, but he could be in a few weeks. So yeah, he looks great in the off-season. Well, if you talk about the off-season, here's a bodybuilder that is in a forever off-season. He decided to stop competing, of course, a long time ago, and he's retired now. He's almost like 60 years old. Of course, Dorian Yates, my favorite bodybuilder of all time, who just got back into the gym because he had a shoulder surgery. He dislocated his shoulder. He hasn't been able to train for 12 weeks, and now he's back. He did a light workout. And I just wanted to mention this and welcome him back to the world of lifting weights after 12 weeks. Guys, that's 3 months of not working out. I'm sure he's really happy to get a little pump going on. And he didn't lose any size, really. I mean, he doesn't even have to train. He maintains all the size. So it's really awesome to see him looking great, looking fit, looking happy. So enjoy the workouts, Dorian. Oh, well, there is somebody who we don't even know if he's in off-season or not, or he's prepping. I mean, he's kind of teasing us with his posts lately. In this one, he says, that smirk, and he's winking at us. So what are we supposed to think? What are we supposed to make out of this? Is he suggesting that he's smirking because he plans on competing sometime soon? Maybe like New York Pro, he can jump in and win that show. It's a huge show, guys, like after Mr. Olympia and Arnold, that's basically New York Pro. I mean, at least it used to be back in the day. It was Night of Champions, third best show in the world. Now, it's more of Arnold Classic Australia. I think that's much more competitive show than New York Pro, but nonetheless, it's a big title, you know? So he can win the New York Pro. I think he won it before, but he can win it again and qualify for the Mr. Olympia and then do the Mr. Olympia. So I don't know if he plans on doing that, but he looks to be 6 weeks out, sure, yeah, he can get lean 6 weeks, I mean, lean enough. He doesn't even have to be super shredded with his structure, with his completeness, with his size and everything. He's a great bodybuilder, he's a really good bodybuilder. He can win the Mr. Olympia, I think, so easily if he just nails it with the conditioning. So if he decided to do New York Pro, I think he can get ready and win that show easily and qualify for the Mr. Olympia. I don't know if that's the plan, but if you guys think, tell me down below, what do you think? Is he planning on competing? Is he looking almost ready? Is he getting ready? What do you think? Alright, we also have an update of another retired or a bodybuilder that is taking a break, I'm not really sure. Jeremy Buendia, not really a bodybuilder, he used to be a bodybuilder, but then he decided to do Man's Physique and he was Mr. Olympia for, I don't know, maybe like 4 or 5 times. I'm not exactly the biggest fan of Man's Physique, but everybody knows about Jeremy because he was a champion for so long and he was involved in a lot of drama and he had a lot of incidents about him. So basically this is his physique right now. He says he hasn't been training for 8 weeks because he has a herniated disc in his neck and his lower back. So he is going through some trouble. So he's talking about his diet here and that he hasn't been using gear or even TRT for a while, and this is his natural look, basically. He also says that he's not really eating good enough, but based on what he wrote, it doesn't sound that bad. He says he has 2 to 3 solid meals and 2 really high protein shakes. Sounds good enough. I mean, I don't think that's too bad. And as far as his looks, he looks great. If he's really off the gear, off of TRT, he looks great. I mean, the arms are looking really good. Yeah, that pack that his store is showing, but it's not really that bad. I mean, the legs are pretty big for a man's physique guy. Overall, no, he's not in a shape to compete and be the top men's physique competitor, but for somebody who is off the gear, who is off the training even, as he says, he looks great, really. I mean, if he fixes his problems and if he decides to come back, I don't know how well would he do because of the back tear, but he can probably be in the top still. He has all the muscle, really. He has the genetics. That little imbalance is gonna hurt him for sure, but he can get back to the game and he can still be a very good men's physique competitor. I'm sure about that. What do you think? And for the final story today, we have Michal Krizo, an absolute monster. And take a look at his physique right now. I'm not sure exactly how far from the show he is, but whichever show he decides to do, it's IBB Elite Pro, so I'm not really sure about those shows, but whichever he does, he's gonna win it. He looks absolutely amazing. I've been telling you guys, this is gonna be his best shape ever. Just take a look at his harness and the conditioning and this shape and the size that he kept. He looks like a freaking Greek god. He doesn't need CGI like Sergi Constance needed for Justice League. I mean, if he had more of a Hollywood kind of looking face, he could have got that role of Zeus and he wouldn't have to... They wouldn't have to do any CGI because this is just looking absolutely unreal. Unreal, right? I'm really curious, what does it look like against the top pros in IBB Pro League? And I really hope we're gonna see that. I really hope so. What do you guys think? How would he fare against the top bodybuilders from the Mr. Olympia? And do you think he will level transfer to the Pro League? Come on, Michal. Tell me, guys, down below in the comment section, do you want to see him in Pro League? If everybody is talking about this, the chances are bigger of him actually doing it. So that's gonna do it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed all these updates, tell me down below and like the video, please. And for more updates, I'm gonna be posting a ton of content in the future. Subscribe to this channel. All the best, guys, and bye-bye.